The African Charter on Governance, Democracy and Elections basically is a framework document that provides a basis for promoting good governance, rule of law, human rights and elections in Africa. It is a document that was arrived at by member states of the African Union. Before this charter came into place, there were two important dimensions that we need to take note of. First, that democracy and elections especially and good governance was hitherto seen as something that is foreign to Africa. It is imposed by the Western countries, Europeans to be particular, and Americans maybe. And so the African member states came together. This document was a realization by the African member states that these elections, good governance, are things that are important for member states of the African Union. So they came up with this document here. But secondly, and perhaps more importantly, in Africa, before this document was signed by a number of African countries in 2008, there were a number of what they call unconstitutional changes of government. What that means is basically there were a number of coups and overthrows of government that hitherto across Africa. So one of the key things that is really running through this charter is the fact that they want democracy to take root and not unconstitutional changes of government or military coups across Africa. To date, we have 46 out of the 54 countries have signed up to this charter. But beyond the signing of the charter, this charter is supposed to be ratified or reviewed by our parliament and adopted by the respective parliaments of the African countries. To date also, we have 34 member states of the African Union that have ratified this document in their parliaments, meaning that they can now take it as a national document or law to be used in those countries. This is such a relief because it provides guidance on how elections are supposed to be conducted, on a representative government, on human rights, on rule of law. Values, as I said, hitherto were attributed to the West, to Western Europe, to North America, and that it was not part of African way of doing things, that Africa only had dictators and so on. So the fact that African leaders came together, expressed the will of the African people, provides for us a basis to demand that this thing that is called democracy, this thing that is called governance, this thing that is called election, is not strange to Africa. It is something that African states have owned, and therefore it empowers citizens actually to demand for elections, free and fair elections for that matter, to demand for human rights and rule of law, and to demand for accountability in governance. You may want to know that between 2008 and to date, which is 2020, we've had about 34 coups or military overthrows in Africa. And that number 34 seems to be magical because we also have 34 member states of the African Union that have signed and ratified the charter. And I think that it is important for us to place a value on elections and on constitutional changes of government, on good governance and on rule of law and human rights, as opposed to coups, as opposed to dictatorships, as opposed to violations of human rights and so on. So this charter here is a reference point for African leaders who committed themselves to signing this, and to the different institutions of government that are supposed to provide for the ratification and implementation of this charter. But more importantly, this charter is important for citizens to demand accountability. As civil society, it also provides for us as a checklist to see, really, is our government, our political actors in this country, political parties, political movements, and the government in power right now, are they living up to this charter that is significant in promoting democracy? This charter makes me feel proud as an African. First and foremost, is a document that you don't find in Latin America. I'm not sure we have one in the Americas. I'm also not sure that we have one in Asia. The African Union, through its member states, is the only sub-regional organization that has explicitly put in a charter issues of democracy, human rights, rule of law, and elections. Even the United Nations is not explicit on whether or not a government is there by elections, whether it is a monarch or whether it is a dictatorship, and so on. So this is the importance of the African Charter on Elections, Democracy, and Governance.